Welcome all of you to look at this final session in aldol condensation. This is cross aldol we are looking at. Suppose you are taking an aldehyde that has alpha hydrogens and also another aldehyde that does not have any alpha hydrogens. This has no alpha carbon at all. And if you try to react with them, this mixture in a basic medium, then of course the formaldehyde is not able to make any enol as it does not have any alpha hydrogens. So it is the acetaldehyde that makes a nucleophile, that is enol form, the CH2 minus CHO that attacks the carbonyl carbon, which is an electrophile. So obviously the first step is this CH2CHO minus ion attacking this carbonyl carbon of formaldehyde due to this shift. Now as you are getting CH being attacked by CH2CHO, right? Eventually, this will pick up a proton from water, from the medium, you will be getting HOHH locked to CH2CHO. So this is a product, probably you can name it as 3-hydroxypropanal. If you are heating, happily it can lose water to give you CH2 double bond CHCHO known as acryl aldehyde. Notice this is one of the products along with the dimerization of acetaldehyde. You know, when acetaldehyde also undergoes aldol as such with itself, dimerizes to give a product. In addition to that, this is second product. If you want that product, you can write happily CH3CHOH CH2CHO. This is dimerization product, which is of course 1, 2, 3, 4, 3-hydroxybutanal. Even this can lose water on heating to give you CH3CH double bond CH C double bond OH. Well, in addition to these products, this reaction surprisingly continues. What happens is, you know, at the end of first step in the cross aldol, you got a product like this before you heat it, that is CH2OH CH2CHO. This part, the CH2CHO part, has come from your acetaldehyde due to conversion of one of the alpha hydrogen, due to the loss of one of the hydrogens, and the resulting nucleophilic CH2 minus CHO was being attacked by formaldehyde. You know that. Now, what happens is the product has still two more alpha hydrogens. So the saga of divorce, the saga of continuation of CH2 into another CH minus continues. So one more cross aldol becomes possible with another formaldehyde. You will be getting CH2OH already there, new CH2OH and this C double bond OH. So the second cross aldol product is this. This again continues with one more molecule of formaldehyde to convert all the three hydrogens of acetaldehyde into CH2OH groups. CH2OH, 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 and of course CHO. This product is again reacting with formaldehyde in basic medium. Though it has no alpha hydrogens, the reaction continues And this type of reaction is known as Cannizzaro reaction. Due to Cannizzaro reaction, this can further undergo a reduction to give you CH2OH, 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 and this becomes CH2OH. This particular product known as a kind of pentaerythritol is resulting, and it is something like, you know, methane, where four hydrogens are replaced by CH2OH groups. So in this course of reaction, how many moles of a formaldehyde are reacting with acetaldehyde? First 3 moles in a routine aldol condensation, and finally 2 more moles of formaldehyde in a typical Cannizzaro reaction. So total number of moles reacting here are 5. Therefore, this can be a typical neat question. In a basic medium, 1 mole of acetaldehyde, in order to give a final product, pentaerythritol, how many moles of formaldehyde is reacting? Answer is 5. Now, the acetaldehyde molecule can also react with benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde has no alpha hydrogen, so only this should make carbon ion or particular nucleophile that attacks this carbonyl carbon. So in presence of base in this cross aldol, you will be getting C double bond OH. This will migrate here. The carbon ion resulting due to the alpha hydrogen loss to OH minus will attack here. This results in CH2, CHO. It is attacking the carbonyl carbon of benzaldehyde, O minus. This is H, this is your benzene. And now eventually it can gain a proton from water to give you, CH, OH, CH2, CHO. And this product, obviously on heating, can lose water to give you what is popularly known as cinnamaldehyde. This is the second product. The first possible product is, of course, the acetaldehyde can combine with itself in basic medium to give you CH3, CHOH, CH2, CHOS, one possible product. So total number of products you are getting is 1 plus 1, 2. If you don't want two products, if you want only one product, well, take acetaldehyde, add a little bit LDA, that is lithium diisopropylamide. You are making enol, preventing the dimerization. The reaction proceeds to give only one product. So this is a story of aldol condensation. Well, what is Cannizzaro reaction? We will be looking at in the next video. Thank you very much.